Morning students of class 10, welcome back to the online portal class. So now let's begin our lesson in English. The footprints without feet, that's lesson 5. In our previous class we have talked about the griffin was given a chase by the shopkeepers of the London store. Because he went there to keep himself warm and to have something. In the evening when all the shopkeepers went out, the door was locked and he enjoyed himself there, covering himself with warm clothes and eating whatever he could find there. And in the morning he got up very late, so he was panicked. And the shopkeepers gave him a chase and he had to open his clothes quickly so that he gets invisible and could not be seen. And somehow he managed to escape from those people while on the run. Now, today there are altogether 7 points I have written over here. Number 1, once more. Once more, griffin. Griffin means the scientist who used to get invisible. Because of his discovery, once more Griffin was out in the street. He was out in the street once more, as he was given a chase by the people of the London store, because he got up very late. If he had got up or woke up early, then everything would have been normal. But he woke up very late in the morning and that's why he was in trouble. Now he had to run away again, taking out all the good clothes he had put on the last night. Number 2, now he decided to try. Now he was, it was a cold winter day. It was winter. The day was very cold. Chilly wind was blowing. And he decided to try again the stock of theatrical. That is a theater. Whatever things are required in the theater, the shop used to sell. That is called theatrical. A shop that sells items for the dramas and plays. There you will find various costumes, various makeups, the artificial hair, mustache, and everything. All sorts of things you will find in that. You will get in that shop. He tried to go there, and he managed to find one. To sell these items were sold theatrical company in the hope of finding some clothes and something to cover his face. He could put on his clothes anywhere. He could enter any shop and put on the clothes. But what about covering the face? He needed something else, and that something he could find only in this shop, theatrical shop, where he could find the makeups. So he went there. Something to hide his face he needed. That's why he went there. He made his way inside easily. He went through the door easily because he was invisible. He entered the room easily. So he made his way easily inside. He came out a little later. Little later, he went inside and dressed up. Everything he put on. And he came out a little late. The man in the counter, he could not notice him entering the shop because he was invisible. And inside the shop there were rooms containing various items. He went inside and dressed himself up, covered his face, put on glasses and coats and so on, and he came out. He made his way in easily. He came out a little later wearing, what did he wear? Wearing bandages around his forehead, wearing bandages. If he puts on the bandage, he could be seen his head. Otherwise, his head would not be seen and people will be suspicious. So, wearing bandages around his forehead, dark glasses, put on dark glasses and a false nose. He put on the false nose, artificial nose. And the whiskers means mustache, and bushy mustache, big thick mustache, so that it could cover his face properly. He tied his head with the bandages, forehead, dark glasses, a false nose, big bushy false whiskers, whiskers means mustache, and a large hat, and a big hat he put on, and a long overcoat. He looked very strange, and to escape, now he has to come out from the shop, and the man is there sitting in the counter. To escape, he attacked the shopkeeper from behind. He attacked the shopkeeper from behind, and the man was fainted, he was hurt, and he attacked the shopkeeper from behind, after hitting him on the head with something, he robbed him. He took out he opened the drawer, whatever money was there in the drawer, he put it in his pocket and he came out. He robbed him. He robbed him of all the money he could find there in the drawer, in the counter. Whatever money was there in the counter, he robbed it. And he came out from the shop. Now number five, to escape from the crowded London. The London city was crowded. To escape from the crowded city of London, he took a train, because now he has got the money which he had robbed from the counter, or from that shop, theatrical shop. So now he has the money now. So to escape from the crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping. He took a train to the village of Iping, where he booked two rooms. There he booked two rooms in a local small hotel that is called inn. He booked two rooms at the local inn, INN. Inn means a small hotel. The arrival of a stranger at this time of the season during winter was very unusual. Nobody used to come there during winter. So the arrival of the stranger in winter was an unusual case. People wondered, who is this man? Very unusual look, very strange. He has got a bandage around his head, a hat, glasses. In winter also the days are gloomy, and he is wearing glasses, false nose and big bushy mustache. A stranger of such an uncommon appearance, he was not like a common man, uncommon appearance, set all tongue wagging. All the people around, neighboring people, the neighbors began to talk about this strange man who had come here in Iping and booked two rooms in a hotel, a small hotel. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife was Mrs. Hall. She was the owner of the hotel. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, who was the owner of the inn, made every effort. She tried very hard to become friendly. She tried every effort to be friendly with the stranger, because the stranger booked two rooms in the hope of earning some money. Mrs. Hall tried to be friendly. Though he looked very strange, it was her customer. So she tried to be friendly with him, and the stranger must have paid her in advance some money. That's why she tried to be friendly with the stranger. The stranger was Griffin, the invisible scientist. So now let's see what happens there in the hotel, in Mrs. Hall's hotel. Let's see in our next class. That's all for today. Thank you for watching the video. Stay safe. Go through online portal every day. Don't miss the classes. And be serious and sincere in your house to study. Be honest and do regular studies properly. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching. We'll meet in the next class.